Maybe we should pick like some suburbs around a big city to live in. That way we have like the country to actually enjoy, but we'll be somewhat near a big city. Like, 'cause I feel like Aaron needs a lot of people. I feel like he enjoys people interaction. He said the other day that like he said the other day that he hasn't been excited by anything in a long time. He said he's been bored most of his life. And I think that's an exaggeration, but I also think he's not completely lying. I think most of the time he is bored, but I think when I've seen him most excited, it's been about people or like people he met at like a job, even if the job's as simple as fucking cash register. Like, he's most excited about his day when he talks about people he met. Like, interesting people, funny people, cool people, just people. Like, he's a people person, as much as he doesn't want to admit it. He's a very social person. He needs person-to-person interaction often to stay, like, mentally healthy, I think. I think it's part of his problem. Some reason. There. What is that noise? Why is there fucking... What the fuck is that noise?
Reloading!
Yeah. Right outside the doors. I realize that now.
Nice.
What the fuck is that noise? It sounds like a fucking level up noise or some shit. Hear it? Ha. Bitch can't take me. I love it. I love it when chargers walk, they start slamming me because I'm down, and I pull out my melee weapon, and then they walk away from me because I'm start fucking swinging it on them. They're like, oh shit, you actually hurt. Okay, okay, interesting. I feel like on this map, we need to have chargers and maybe like the spitters that can jump on walls and shit. Because I feel like if they tried what we tried, we'll just beat them with that. But I don't know what they're gonna do. I'm gonna try being a stinger. And fucking. Normally I like the Hawkers. They're like my favorite. But I don't think they're nearly as good on PvP. I think the Stalkers that bring people away from shit are overall better. But if they try and hole up in that house like we did, or in this garage like we did, then the one that spits a fuck ton will just get them. So it all depends. I feel like we just need to learn the meta, or like what to do in certain maps. Like, cause PvP really does play different than PvE. You can't just fucking... Yeah, I understand, Ghost Killer. He's separated from his team. We'll just get who's separated. He's running around separated. Yeah, this guy's all alone. Let's get him. Just team up on the guy who's not with his fucking team. Just get him dead. Sightlines. Oh yeah, get the car alarm involved. Oh, that sounds nice. I love the way the fucking big fat guys headbang instead of fucking like teabag. 2 bonus damage. Okay, yeah, let's do that. Do an upgrade. Well, make sure to use your upgrade points, guys. The early upgrades do matter. You get like 1 upgrade with your points early. They're like, they got a quarter of their bar left to scavenge, so let's use your upgrades or save them. And fucking let's. I don't know why you'd save them, because the first upgrade is 50 points anyway, so like it's best just to use it. Let's just be a fucking stalker, then I'll try and drag people away. They don't seem too concerned about fucking staying together. Let's just fucking drag them away and make them split up. Really specific kind of like fuck. Yeah, I'm not great at that. I'm not good at that kind of spitter interaction. Alright, they have a minute. We need to get them. Yeah, keep dragging away. I think I fucked up. I think it should have been a wretch instead of a spitter. I think it might have done more damage early on to make the late game easier. Wow, we really leaned all into the Reekers, huh? I guess let's fucking do it. Let's lean all into the Reekers and fucking... What are we doing? Wretches, I guess? Or Exploders? On this map? I don't know what would be better. What are they gonna do? Are they gonna go from place to place? We have a lot of... open holes in the ceiling and shit. I'm gonna be a wretch. I'm gonna upgrade. This guy, he's alone. I'm trying to slow him down with my puke. Ah, blew up.
Gotta reload.
Come on, they're out in the open. We should be able to. What's the open good for? The open's good for chargers. God damn it. The fact that there's so many maps that you can do is actually kind of fucked for, like, everyone, because there's so much good and bad for survivors, and, like, I feel like there's actually a good, healthy mix of multiplayer maps on this game. Like, that's hard to do in a game like this, where it's similar to Left 4 Dead, where it was either, you know, it leaned one way or the other. I feel like there's enough maps, you go back and forth a bunch of times. Abandon their partners, they're trying to survive. Get him, charge him, just fucking charge him. made it impossible for her to rescue her friend, just get the one that's up. She's trying to res. She's getting it done. She's failed. Just get her. Yeah, there you go. Alright, we got it. 320. No? Why? Why is... Okay, 30. No? Why is it not ending? They're all incapacitated. Who? Fucking one of them? Oh my god, that's a strategy. That's a fucking strat. Fucking A. I guess you don't end the timer if you have a grapple breakout and you're like doing it. I don't know when the timer ends per se, like if you're you have to be constantly doing it, or if you just have it and refuse to use it. But the card where you get a grapple breakout, that apparently is broken because you extend your time by a good 20-30 seconds period. Okay, good to know. It appears the nests have had an unusual effect on the local insect population. Change it, either way. Do not get caught in the swarm. Fucking MP5. Holy shit, the thing's good. Over here. You don't have long. Yeah, let's. I don't know what the good strat is to do. They had two people on the porch of the house and two people just fucking wandering. Like, I don't know.
They're on their nice. Way. Bandages!
Heads up! Incoming ridden!
That doesn't look good.
Reloading! It may look bad, but it's not.
Alright, they're just trying to bombard us with pukers on the roof right now. Keep an eye out for them. Two of them on that roof. They upgraded the commons and they upgraded the vomiters. That's all they did.
Here goes nothing!
My hero.
And then they come in with the crushers after we're already down. Wow, okay, I'm learning the strats. It's just there's a different strat for every fucking map. Like there's a whole ass different strat for every fucking map for PvP. Like, because this one's so wide open, you just put points in the commons and the pukers. You just slow people down and let the commons do the damage, and then you put no points into the chargers, but you have one or two people be chargers just to incap people. I think their infected strat was just way better. We were kind of all together, we were just in the open, like they couldn't spawn anywhere specific around us, but there were just too many of them, like we were together, kind of.
You mean this?
Hold them off as long as you can. It appears the nests have had an unusual effect on the local insect population. Do not get caught in the swarm. You should find some weapon crates and ammo on the ground left by the local militia. Make use of them if you need to. Cool. focusing on your position.
Defibrillator here.
Hey, we should stick together.
Here they come. Lots of them.
Use that.
Is sticking together really that hard?
Stick a band-aid on this.
Not a bad start. Dig in and hold them back.
Thank you.
We got Britain inbound, and you need to secure the area. Maintain your positions for as long as possible. There's an unusual swarm of insects as well. Best to stay clear of it. We pulled back the local defenses for evac. Their equipment should still be on the ground. Use it.
Looks like someone left us some intel. Though, if it's out here by itself, probably didn't do them a lot of good.
They're on their way! Get ready!
Not a bad start. Dig in and hold them back.
Today is not the day for dying. I mean, yesterday we came close, but hey, here we are.
It appears the nests have had an unusual effect on the local insect population. Do not get caught in the swarm.
See that?
We pulled back the local defenses for evac. Their equipment should still be on the ground. Use it.
Need that.
That's what I'm telling myself.
Evangelo.
This is my grateful face.
Evangelo's gone.
Let's not wait around for them to come back.
Only two of you left.
Over here!
You got this.
Not a bad start. Dig in and hold them back.
Thank you.
focusing on your area. We need to get the civilians out of the area. We're gonna need you and your team to hold back the Ridden until everyone is out. The Ridden have a new trick up their sleeves. The Horde seems to be protected by what appears to be a swarm of insects. Scavenge any gear you can and prepare yourselves. You don't have long. They're on their way! Get ready! Heads up! Incoming Ridden!
Need that.
So far, so good, but we still got work to do.